arrived here in Punta Cana. Checked into Excellence Resort room 11205. Long night of travel, flew out at midnight. Had a connection through Charlotte, slept for maybe a couple of hours. But let's go ahead and take a look at the room.
Hello. Welcome to our home for the next 5 days. This is our grand entryway.
It's a little insanely large.
First bathroom, half bath.
Half bath, we have guests over, pretty nice. Moving right along down the massive hallway, we come to
our living room slash bar. Everything's included. We got rum, we got gin, we got tequila, we got.
Take a look at the important stuff here. Yeah. Got some black labels, some 1800, which I was kind of impressed with. Grey Goose for the vodka, which is nice. Bombay Sapphire and Barcelo Imperial, which I have not had this rum before, but I will definitely be checking that one out. Got a nice Nespresso maker, although we have people that can bring us other coffees. TV.
A little hidden fridge with all the essentials.
Whatever your plan.
Water, M&M's,
corn. I just realized you got the TV talking, so that might be talking over us, but that's okay. Yeah, M&M's I'm excited about. Coors Light, I'll take it. Diet Coke will definitely get consumed. And as we checked in, they gave us a nice fresh fruit basket. What the thing Robin was most excited about. Yeah, look at that.
Yeah, I've been up for I got 2 hours of sleep in the last, 26 hours now. Just worked 3 shifts in the hospital. Jumped on
a red
eye.
It's Moet Chandon. I looked it up. I'm not a big champagne person, but it's like a $50+ bottle of champagne. We'll take it. Coming out here to the balcony area. Let's see if we can actually get this open. There we go. We have a nice private double lounger thing.
Daybed,
yeah, that's what it's called. Outdoor, kind of messing up the camera there. Have to figure that out. Don't know what it's doing. There we go. Yeah, outdoor jacuzzi, couple individual chairs, that view. I'm not quite a little overcast today, but supposed to be sunnier later in the week. Zoom out here so you get more of the full picture. Coming back inside.
Off of our living room, we have a little, I guess not so little, dining rooms. Apparently you can have a bartender come to your room for an hour and make you drinks. So, don't know where we'll do that. Maybe here, maybe in the living room. Maybe.
Probably in the living room, I think. Yeah. But this is like your formal dining room because you can actually have any food from any of the restaurants on property delivered to your room by your concierge butler type person. And so you can eat that here. But you don't actually have to go wait in line. Or if you do want to eat at any restaurants, they said we just text them, we don't have to wait in line, we just go and eat.
This is like a service door. Here that goes out back, and then this is like a little room where I think they can put like your room service in without coming in. There's like a little door that they can put. I think that's what it's for.
Yeah, it is.
They put the food in, then you can grab it, and they don't even have to come in the room.
Yep, and you can put your dirty stuff there too, and they just come and get it, so they don't actually have to come into your room. Some nice chandeliers, and then to the bedroom, right across from the living room.
We are celebrating our 5-year anniversary this week. So I'm guessing that's why the roses are on the bed. Or maybe the swans, or they just did that. Maybe they did that one.
We did tell them it was our anniversary, but I will see if this is something that happens every day where there's a different animal or what, but very pretty.
But the most important thing is this mirror right here.
That's not the most important thing. Let's go look here first. We have a little wallet that they gave us so we can carry around our key cards in. And absolutely unnecessarily large mirror. which makes the TV actually look small, and it is a huge TV.
I don't know. I don't understand the point of the chair. Right?
Yeah, that's a little weird, but it's fine.
Just a random chair.
It's okay.
It's okay. In case you're so drunk you can't make it to the bed.
And our indoor jacuzzi soaking tub. Next to that, wow, I am just having issues with my thing today. We have this
vanity
mirror. I assume Robin will be doing her hair or makeup there or something.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Not really sure.
And then, double sinks. I will be wearing those slippers later. I hope there's a gown.
Yes, there was in one of the closets.
Yes.
I saw a
robe. I put my robe on. Another toilet.
Very exciting. Toilet.
And then this is like a whole other room, but it's the shower.
Like, yeah, this is like...
Look at this thing.
I mean, I'm zoomed out on 0.5, and I can't even fit
Oh, wait, wait. No, I can't touch the walls.
Yeah. It is a gigantic shower. And I guess we did not look at the closet, so let's go look at the walk-in closet. This room is just around 2,000 square feet, I think they said, so larger than my first house. You have a steamer there to steam your clothes, there's robes, there's extra towels and a beach bag, our bags that they brought up for us, lots of shelves.
Bigger than some people's closets in their own house.
Yeah.
Bigger than our kids' closet. They don't even have
one. Yeah. Okay, well, let's see how this works, because there's like a lot of wavy noise back there, so I'm not sure if you're actually going to be able to hear this or not. Sit rep. We have been hanging out in the room, doing basically nothing, just laying out here and enjoying drinks and the view and the wind, and it's been nice. It is 5:51. We think the celebration-y thing is supposed to be starting at like... maybe 6, maybe 6:30, not 100% sure. Like typical island, they weren't super specific about that. So we're gonna go down, see if that's starting. If not, we'll grab a drink at the bar. If so, we'll go in and see what kind of like buffet, Dominican food sort of thing. Supposedly there's like performers, I think, or something. So I don't know, we'll see. And yeah, it's about the plan for the night. Thank you for adding so much to that clip. That was really helpful.
I'm sorry. I'm so tired. I worked 3 days in a row, 12 hours just in the hospital, jumped on a red eye, got 2 hours sleep on the plane, had a major headache. Alcohol is helping. Food helped too.
This is going to get better.
Yeah. I don't know if I'll make it to like 9 o'clock, to be honest. Sleep last night, went to bed about 8 o'clock?
Yeah, so we went down to that thing that we talked about last night, the Dominican Independence Day thing. She lasted through dinner and that was about it, and finally was like, yeah, we need to go back to the room. So we didn't really record anything last night. We just had dinner and then came back to the room and we're in bed by, I don't know, 8 o'clock, 8:30, something like that.
Woke up at 5:30 this morning, ready to go.
Exactly what I told her was gonna happen if we went to bed super early. So we woke up, went to the gym, did a workout. They actually have a really nice gym here. Maybe we'll do a little tour of that another day. They have like actually barbells and bumper plates and a whole bunch of stuff. So I got a workout in, got some coffee, had breakfast, and now getting ready to head down to the pool, the one you can kind of see behind us there. We have a little palapa thingy. We're gonna play some volleyball, hopefully pool volleyball, beach volleyball, something like that. What else?
Drink.
Yeah, that. Trying to see if we can, we saw some people horseback riding on the beach last night, so we're trying to see if we can do that one of the evenings this week. We'll see. We texted our person, and they're also, I have to go find our concierge person, because he said to talk to him about our beach dinner and stuff like that we have later this week. So, yeah, busy day.
What you drinking?
Probably diet.
She copied me. They have a whole menu here that I showed her. And she copied me. Lots of this has lots of juice, though, so it's going to be very sweet.
Gotta save my calories, you know?
Still a decent pool bar menu. Try some of this later. I like the, I might have to get a banana daiquiri with lots of rum at some point. Like that. The Bahama Mama is also another good pool drink.
Margaritas.
Lots of margaritas. Well, yeah, they got strawberry. They got a watermelon margarita, which you don't really see too much, so might have to give that a shot at some point. Not expecting a lot. We did have a bottle of 1800 tequila in our room, though, so that'd be better. I don't even know what tequila they have out here. There's not a lot going on back there. But the rums are good. The the Dominican rums are very good. This is true. Met some friends from volleyball that we're hanging out with over at the swim-up bar now, though. This should pass within a little bit, and then it's supposed to be sunny the rest of the afternoon.
It's coming down, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Is it cold?
All right. Panda's going to try and get on this little float. Oh, and... Comfy?
Yeah, I play volleyball like this.
Yeah. You can also do some B-ups. Try doing a B-up. Yeah, try it. Come on. Try it. Well, you gotta put your arms back and then B-up. There you go.
Settle you.
All right, well, Robin is finishing getting ready. We're about to head out to get ready for dinner. Had a great day, hung out by the pool the entire day. Played a bunch of pool volleyball, met a lot of really cool people. Definitely this resort is more social. You know, we've been to a bunch of sandals resorts and others where sometimes people kind of stay to themselves. Here you've got people that are mixing and getting to know each other. We were doing some filming and met some fun people through that. You'll see some of that on here. But yeah, just really great vibe overall. Probably going to meet up again with some of the other people that are here through the end of the week as well, so I'm sure we'll see them again for like volleyball or for drinks or something. But tonight we're going to Lobster House. Got a great menu, lobster, steaks, stuff like that. Caribbean lobster is a little bit different from, you know, your typical lobster you might find in the U.S. We're going to do that, maybe grab some evening cocktails, and kind of see what takes us. There's some evening events going on tonight. There's a virtual DJ, I think there's a live band. So we'll see where we end up, and I'll try to film as much of it as I can. See you guys in a bit. you can hear me. They just started this 70s show. Say hi. She just got finished dancing. I was sitting here.
Is still sleeping. We were up pretty late last night. We had fun at like that club dancing music thing. I just came down to get us some coffee. You see here. Grabbed us some chairs on the, actually the loungers facing the ocean this time. So that'll be nice. Heading back to go see if she's ready to get up and then figure out some breakfast. All right, we have a very important update. She's alive.
Hi.
It is like 11 a.m. finally. Out of bed, she woke up with tummy feeling very bad, very ouchies. So we'll see how long we manage to last today at the pool. But she's trooping along.
Trying to.
She's alive still, barely. We found I got this earlier this morning at a nice little palapa facing the beach. But they put our towels, we're still here, going and installing it. Quite a nice view this morning, transfer. Oh, there's a lot to do that. Okay. Robin is laying down in the palapa, still not feeling super great. She's not having, you know, stomach pain anymore, but just not feeling so good. I am making my first attempt at putting my feet into the Atlantic Ocean here. It's a red flag day still, so we can't really swim, but I'm kind of curious to see how cold this is, so let's see. Water's not freezing, it's definitely not warm, but yeah, these waves are pretty intense. Can't go out very far, you can feel it kind of definitely sucking you out in just even from up here on the very edge of the beach. but pretty nice. Cannot complain. I'd love to get out there and actually have some fun in the ocean, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen on this trip. Size waves. My hat looks super cool, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Very, very. Oh yeah. It's like a pineapple pirate. All
There's right. Like no clouds today. It was so cloudy the last couple of days. Raining on and off.
We're also filming this on the GoPro as opposed to my iPhone, so I have no idea how this is going to turn out. It is in a waterproof case, which means I'm not sure if you can hear me or not, but that's okay. Waves and stuff, this probably is the beach for you. We like waves. We've been to, you know, Jamaica and other places that had really calm beaches. We're relaxing and all that, but not super fun. This is pretty fun. No one out here has a boogie board or anything, which is kind of surprising. Maybe it's because of the red flag, but hang on, this is gonna hurt. I'm kind of surprised because this would be amazing waves for that type of thing. No idea again if you can hear me or not. This is going to be fun to edit this video. If you see me looking around, it's going to keep an eye. These waves are crazy and they're not uniform. They don't break kind of all at the same time. So you can be in one area and have something little like that, but like 10 feet that way. It's a wall of water that's gonna knock you over.
So keep that in mind if you're coming to Punta Cana, specifically to stay at Excellence. Supposedly, if you go down that way, there is a calmer area of beach with less waves. We haven't seen that yet. And if you go to the Caribbean side, supposedly that is even more calm and tranquil. That's where all the excursions and sails and stuff like that go out of Odear. That one almost took me out. But we're staying here, hanging out here, enjoying it. It's a lot of fun.
Okay. We are just getting ready to check out. We've got about an hour, a little over an hour, so we have to be out of the room. Our transportation is picking us up at 12:10 to head to the airport. We're there 3 hours early. But wanted to put together some final thoughts. This one's kind of tough and interesting. So we'll talk through a little bit. We ended up not filming probably as much as we planned on this trip. We'll kind of explain why in this. But I guess let's start out with the good stuff. I'm just gonna hit on some of the categories like the hotel, the room, the food, and then we'll talk about some of the others.
Can we start with a drive over?
Sure. Go for it.
So we had our own private service coming over. It was through the hotel, Suburban, I think. Driver didn't say much to us. A lot of times we've like had drivers where they'll tell us, you know, about their country and like explain things on the way. This driver was a very aggressive driver. I was like, do they not have driving laws here in the Dominican Republic? He was just flying down the street, honking the horn, going in the left lane to cut over in front of the other cars to go straight. So it was a very like scary first impression coming.
It freaked her out more than me. I mean, the guy was not the best driver for sure. I've done enough travel where I'm kind of used to having some crazy drivers like that. But yeah, if you're not used to it, and it was very just kind of like jerky, so if you get motion sick or anything like that, what we come to find out is that the drivers taking people to resorts basically don't have to follow any laws. Really what we were told is the only law they have to follow is that if the light is red, they have to stop. But like speed limits don't apply. And they don't have to stay in lanes. They can zip in and out and cut people off and whatever because you're taking people to resorts who are going to be spending money and paying taxes. So that can lead to kind of an interesting experience.
Check-in was pretty good. They give you champagne right when they welcome you in. You get a glass of champagne. And then since we were in club level, or Club Excellence is called, right? And we had our own like private person, took us to a private room where went over a few things with us. But our room wasn't ready. We had to wait, like, so we found out like, we got here like
12. We got in early. I mean, we got in before check-in, so it wasn't that bad, yeah. But we did have to wait maybe a couple hours.
Yeah, I think 2:45 is when we
got. Yeah. But talking about Club Excellence for a second, so yeah, there's within the resort, kind of like a bunch of brands do, they have, you know, different tiers at club level. This one was kind of interesting. So we stayed in the Imperial Suite, which is the largest suite on property. And when we checked in with the concierge, the guy gave us his phone number and basically kind of said, you know, I'm here to take care of you for your entire stay. If there's anything you need, text me, call me. You know, whatever. Now, we've stayed at Sandal where we had butler service, which was a very similar offering, and they would give you a phone, you could contact them and stuff through that phone. Yeah, this is not butler service from Sandals, at least not our experience. Like, we never saw the guy again after the first day. It's not like he checked in with us throughout the day. It's not like he brought us stuff by the pool or anything like that. I did text him a few times, and he would eventually get back. But it would be hours later. Like, I would send him a text about, hey, can we get a dinner reservation here tonight? And maybe 4 or 5 hours later, I get an okay back. That was a little kind of disappointing. I wasn't necessarily expecting him to be waiting on us hand and foot, but it's just, if you're used to like the butler experience at Sandals or some of the other resorts, this is definitely not that. But you do get elevated rooms, better liquor, access to a dedicated restaurant, an area of the beach,
So there's definitely some perks to it, but just don't go in thinking it's going to be about your service.
Oh, we didn't even know we were going to have this.
All right, so then overall resort, just like the layout, the quality of the resort, everything. I'm looking out the window, fresh memory. in general, we were very happy.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a well-maintained property. Yeah, it's beautiful.
Very well-maintained compared to some of the Sandals property we went to for start the ballpark.
Yeah. And this is an older property. This is their first one that was ever built. So I'm pleasantly surprised at how well-maintained it is. Like I said, nothing seems falling apart or gross or anything like that.
People are really nice here. Everyone says hello, asks you how your day's doing. I don't think we had one person walk by and not say hi to us.
Yeah. The service in general has been very good. I would give it a 4 out of 5, not a 5, simply for one reason, and this is kind of a small nitpick, but there were multiple times where I would go up to one of the bars and I would ask them to make a drink from their menu and to make it with a dark rum instead of a white rum, like a mojito or something, right? And they would always say yes, and then they would just go make the drink with the regular way that they always make it. And it was every single, I never got them to actually do something that I was asking where it wasn't kind of a standard recipe. That was really the only, I think, service level thing that kind of bugged me.
And then we did call for them to restock our mini fridge and to bring another bottle of rum and glasses. Like, when we came in, I think there was 8 glasses total. You had shot glass, you had 2 shot glasses, 2 wine glasses, 2 kind of beer glasses, 2 short glasses. And we called, 3 or 4 times to have them bring us new glasses, and they never brought them.
No, they still never brought them. They've been taking the dirty glasses, but they are not replenishing them with clean glasses. So it's but again, overall, in comparison to some of the very poor service with the experience at some Sandals resorts before, we were pleasantly surprised here.
Room service, we ordered room service and within 30 minutes we got our food. There was time we ordered at Sandals and never came one night.
Yeah. With that said, I will say room service wasn't the best.
But yeah.
The breakfast that they brought us, we got a champagne breakfast one morning. It was awful. I mean, the eggs were cold. They were, it was just not. It was
well,
not
there's good. Only it was only one option. It was salmon eggs benedict.
Yeah.
That's my kind of thing, but it wasn't fresh tasting, which I don't think they have salmon around here anyway.
No, no salmon is not a thing. So then let's see, what else? Room, loved the room.
Yeah,
this room is spectacular. Value for money on this room, again, as we mentioned it earlier in the videos, $4,500 for 6 nights. We're here in the end of February, beginning of March, kind of prime rolling into spring break season. Excellent value for money. And again, room is just 2,000 square feet, gorgeous. Sorry, we're hearing somebody knocking up there and I don't know what it is. Okay, so that brings us to sort of, kind of the question of, all right, would we ever come back? Do we recommend this resort? And that's kind of the elephant in the room.
Well, before we get to that, another thing, we're on the Atlantic side of the island, so it is super wavy out there. So you're not gonna have any water sports. You're not gonna have any snorkeling right outside like you can with most resorts. You can usually just walk into the water and snorkel. You're not gonna have any kayaking. You're not gonna have any paddle boarding. So that was kind of because I like doing water sports like that. And then
the pool complex is amazing, though.
Yeah.
It does make up for it. The pool here
the
is
pool does, yeah.
enormous.
I mean, it's nice going out in the waves, and the beach is, the sand is really soft. The nice thing, too, not many vendors. I felt like in Barbados, there was a lot more vendors on the beach, and they were kind of more pushy. I think we saw the same 3 people, every day. One guy with a monkey, one guy with 2 parrots, and then someone selling cigars. But, you just say no, and they leave you alone, where other places, they're kind of push you.
So back to what I was saying. There's the knocking going on here. It's gonna be terrible to edit, but elephant in the room. Robin, as we mentioned earlier, got sick on the second day here, second full day. She checked in
I woke up 3:30 in the morning with these cramps that I've never experienced cramps like them. It was almost like contractions, like when you're giving birth. Slept in till about 11. I tried multiple times just to like get up and get ready, and I just end back up in bed. Like I had to like breathe through my cramps. They hurt so bad. So that was a bummer. It was running to the bathroom multiple times, not vomiting. Figured that out. Was the other one.
Get that detail.
Yeah.
But I mean, she was seriously sick. Like it was, like she mentioned, barely could get up, couldn't get out of bed for the majority of the day. And so that on its own would have been just, okay, bad luck, you know, whatever. We met a substantial number of people on this trip, all of which had somebody in their party get sick with the exact same symptoms in the last week. Like I'm at least 10 other people that I can think of had one or more people in their party come down with this. Some of them were down for multiple days. Most of them, it was a day, and then they were still not feeling great, but able to get back up. We have never seen that at any other resort. We've been to Mexico, we've been to Barbados, we've been to Jamaica.
Turks and Caicos.
Not only have we never gotten sick, we've never known anyone that got sick at one of those resorts. So the fact that so many people here did, it is not good. There is a problem. We heard some people say that it's the milk. You should avoid the dairy, or like these coconut drinks that they make that have dairy in them because the dairy's not refrigerated.
Well, it was funny because there is a drink called Coco Loco.
Yes.
And it's made with the coconut. They have coconuts everywhere here. Like you can get a drink out of coconut all the time. You want to have a drink made and then put in the coconut. Everyone who had the Coco Loco got sick. I had that's the first drink I had when we got here.
Yeah.
And I got sick 2 days later, and everyone said they had that drink. So we don't know if it's that drink.
Yeah. I mean, I never drank one, so I didn't get sick. I did have milk, but the only milk I would have was in my coffee in the morning and just a little bit. And that I think they get enough turnover there, and it's an indoor thing that's probably refrigerated.
Yeah, it's not. It's
but I could not in good conscience recommend this resort to anybody, based on the amount of people we saw here that got sick and how sick Robin got. I hope that they get it fixed, but to be honest, this actually kind of makes us, I'm not put off against Excellence, the resort like brand. I think they're probably okay. They've got other resorts in other countries. It does make me think twice about coming back to Punta Cana or Dominican Republic in general. I'd like to think it's just a one-off experience, but way too many people.
Yeah, it makes me really nervous. Like, I've never been that sick and in that much pain that I would be scared to come back. Like, I don't want to ever experience that again. I wouldn't wish that on anyone to have to experience that. Like, yeah. I just thought of it.
So that's why we ended up not filming nearly as much. She wasn't feeling great. I was just happy, you know, it ended up not ruining our anniversary. She was kind of feeling okay enough by our actual anniversary day. So we still did some, still had a really good time. Like in general, we had a great trip. It's just, that is a major red flag. That is a big, big issue.
And the other nice thing is we met like a lot of nice people here that we talked to like every day and hung out with. I think this is the first trip that we actually, like we're very social with people and we talk to people, but this was the first time where it's like, oh, we hang out with them and then see them again the next day, you know. Hang out with them, play volleyball together.
We would even just run into like people that we had seen at volleyball or somewhere, and they'd say, oh, hey, you know, they recognize you and start talking. And it was like, oh, yeah, not all resorts have that. So,
there's a lot of nice people.
So I guess that's it. I mean, fantastic week, gorgeous property, but just one really, really bad problem that hopefully they get taken care of, because if you're spending this kind of money, I mean, granted, we got a great deal, right? But it's $4,500 for a week. You shouldn't have to worry that the milk you're drinking is tainted or something like that in a resort of this level. So unfortunately, cannot recommend it. Do not recommend anybody that come here. Hopefully in the future, they get it fixed and other people don't have the same experience. But for now, I would stay away.
Yeah. definitely bring Pepto Bismol because it's like $15 here. We actually talked to some people who said like activated charcoal. They thought that might help. I guess I would be prepared. I'm going to another country.
All right, well, we're going to head out. We fly home. We've got 4 days at home and then head off to New York for another trip. So we'll see you all on the next one. Bye.